folks, we're going to do Whistle by Flo Rida today. So first of all, let's get the chords up on the screen. So there's only four chords to this song, as you can see. We've got A minor, we've got F, we've got C, and we've got G. There's no capo needed today as well, so what I'll do is I'll just show you the chords, and then we'll see if we can get this picking pattern through. So A minor first of all, I'm going to take our first finger and we're going to pop it on the second string, the first fret. Middle and third finger are going to sit on the second fret on the fourth and third string. I'm going to strum down from the A string. That gives our A chord. Okay. Now, our F chord is going to be played slightly different to probably how you would usually play it. A lot of people are taught an F usually like this, maybe just using four fingers like this, or maybe like a bar version like this. An easier way to play this today, is assuming our thumb is big enough, is to put the thumb for the first fret on the sixth string. So we get that, okay? And then what's going to happen is you're going to build up a little step from the first finger here, where it was for the A minor, second string, first fret, and then go up with the middle finger, second fret, third string, and then third finger is going to be third fret on the fourth string. So that's going to give us the sixth string played. This one will hopefully be muted out. We won't actually be picking that anyway, but we'll try and mute that string out with the thumb. So the thumb's coming across, fretting the sixth string note, and then muting out the fifth one. Then we've got fourth string, third string, second string. Okay? And then after that, we'll need to do a C. So a C is pretty simple. If we take our F for a starter, we just have to remove the thumb, put the middle finger up, and then the third finger up above that. Okay? So that'll give us a C chord to play down from the A string. That'll be our fifth string. That'll be, okay? Then to finish off, we're going to do a G. I'm going to do an old school G. So what we're going to do is we're going to move our third finger up a string, our middle finger up a string. We're going to lift off our first finger and put our pinky down just on the high E string there, which is the first string, and that's going to be the third fret. It's going to give us that sound. Okay, now depending on how you want to strum this, there's obviously mainly a picking pattern in this, but if you wanted to strum it through, you could just do four down strums with an up. Like that sort of idea, okay? So that would be one, two, three, four, and. Or down, 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 up. It's a good little start to practice. So that would be four played on the A minor, four on the F, four on the C, four on the G, like that, and that'll give us the sound of the song. But what happens mainly in the tune is you'll hear a picking pattern, especially at the start and the main part of the song, you'll hear a picking pattern. So let's talk about this picking pattern, and we'll put the tab up on the screen so you can see this. Okay, so our tab, as you can see, it outlines four notes for each chord, okay? So you're going to be picking four notes for the A minor, four notes for F, four notes for G, four notes for C. So let's go through what these notes are. So let's get our A minor shape down first of all. There we are. We're going to pick string number 5 and then 4. So it's going to be 5, 4, then 2, 3. So 5, 4, 2, 3. That's string numbers, okay? Then we're going to change to our F shape, so thumb at the 6th string at the 1st fret, build up your F shape. We're going to pick here, 6, 4, 2, 3, okay, so 6, 4, 2, 3. Then we're going to change to the C, so thumb off, move up the 3rd and middle finger up a string. You're going to do 5, 4, 2, 3, okay, and then we're going to change to our G. Middle and third upper string, first finger off, pinky down, and you're going to play 6, 4, 2, 3. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. I'll play it through for you once just so you can hear how it sounds, and then that'll be you hopefully got the tune together. So you can hear how that sounds. That's all there is to the tune, really. You can strum it through, you can pick it through. It's really up to you. Hopefully you've enjoyed this nice quick lesson. Got lots more lessons on my channel, so feel free to check them out. If you enjoyed it, subscribe. If you liked it, press the like button. I'll see you in the next video.